point the British ordering of the British of the British Indian troops. Indian troops to march to Malta in preparation for war against Russia. So this is an event. It is an event. And all these events either reduced the stability of Turkey or created a state of war among the great powers or destroyed the relations among the great powers and then finally created a state of tension that culminated into the calling of the Berlin Congress. So of course, as you have seen, there were factors that led to the calling of the Berlin Congress. But this time presented in form of events. So many times we term them as eventful factors. Eventful what? Factors that led to the calling of the Berlin Congress. So those are the factors which led to the calling of the Berlin Congress, or the factors that resulted into the Balkan crisis of 1875 to 1878. Now, another interesting thing, class, which we have to look at is the impact of the 1878 Berlin Congress. We are now going to the impact of the 1878 Berlin Congress. Impact of the 1878 Berlin Congress. The impact of the 1878 Berlin Congress. I told you that in June, Bismarck perfected the meeting. And finally, the meeting was convened under his guidance and chairmanship. He was a honest broker seeking no territorial gain for Germany. Honest broker seeking no territorial gain for Germany. At the end of it all, a Berlin resolution was endorsed. And when this Berlin resolution was endorsed, and finally resolutions were made, automatically, what was resolved had long-lasting impact, not only upon the powers that attended, but generally upon the whole of Europe and the world, as we are going to see. So the impact of the Congress of Berlin was one, A, was short-term. It was short term. The impact of Berlin B was long term. It was long term. All the powers that were involved in the Ottoman Empire were affected, either positively or negatively. So the impact, therefore, was positive. The impact, therefore, was negative. As we are going to see. If you want to understand the impact of the Berlin Congress of 1878, you must, first of all, be in a position to understand the praying patterns within the meeting. What were the praying patterns within the meeting? One, we had Britain. Two, we had France. Three, we had Austria-Hungary. Four, we had Italy. Five, we had Russia. 6 we had Take. The moment you have these praying fathers in the meeting, you will be in the position to generate the impact out of the burden meeting. Out of this, we have what we call the general impact. What we call the general impact. We have what we call the general impact. Like, after the meeting had been convened, what happened? Peace was achieved. The danger of war was averted. Automatically. The drums of war, which Britain had started, supported by Austria against Russia, were put aside. And peace was averted. Next, Serbia, which had been declared an independent state, now became an independent kingdom, and it was recognized by the great powers. So Serbia, as an independent kingdom, was recognized by the great powers. And that was a very significant event in as far as the affairs of the Ottoman Empire was concerned. Serbia, as an independent kingdom, was recognized by the great powers. Yes, what happened? Bismarck's foreign policy was affected somehow, which he had started in 1872. What does it mean? That the Berlin Resolution poisoned the relationship between Austria-Hungary and Russia, and therefore it led to the collapse of the 1872-73 Emperor's League, or the first Dreikaiserbahn under Stalin. So led to the collapse of the Three Emperors League of 1872-73, and this affected Bismarck's foreign policy. And because this one had collapsed, then it partly led to the Berlin Resolution, or the Berlin Congress led to a new wave of alliance system initiated by Bismarck, and that was none other than the 1879 Dio Alliance. So it led to the formation of the 1879 Dio Alliance due to the failure of Austria-Hungary to remain in the same alliance with Russia. Same alliance with Russia. General aspects. What about Bismarck? Bismarck glorified himself. Bismarck became an astonishing, profound figure in the affairs of Europe. So Bismarck became glorified as a man of peace. Automatically, his name ran down into the annals of history as a honest broker who wanted a peaceful Europe, although at the expense of the interest of Germany. General aspects. Yes, when you go to these individual states, praying partners within the Ottoman Empire, What happened to Britain? Of course, what happened to Britain was the Treaty of San Stefan was nullified. So, San Stefan, San Stefan San Stefano Treaty, San Stefano Treaty nullified. San Stefano Treaty nullified. Which means that as the Treaty of San Stefano was nullified, the interests of Russia in the Ottoman Empire were once again checked. They once again checked, and that was an impact. It was an impact. What happened to the big Bulgaria? Big Bulgaria, a puppet state was dismantled. Big Bulgaria, a puppet state was dismantled and was actually divided into three states. Eastern Rumelia. Then Macedonia. Macedonia was born out of the division of Bulgaria. And then the northern part of Bulgaria, which remained in the hands of the Turkish prince. So the big Bulgaria, which had been created by Russia as a puppet state to safeguard her interests, was dismantled, of course, to the appeasement of Disraeli and Sarizi and Sarizbari. Then Britain was able to gain the control of Cyprus from Turkey. Britain gained control of Cyprus from Turkey, as a strategic base in the Mediterranean Sea for her economic and commercial activities. And then two, as a strategic base to monitor the possibilities of Russian violations of the Navy laws. So gain the control of the Cyprus. What was the impact of this? This culminated into the collapse of the Anglo-Turkish relations, because Cyprus belonged to Turkey. And now it is taken by Britain. So the long-lasting relations that had occurred between Britain and Turkey finally collapsed. This explained why Turkey, which had been a long friend of Britain, fought on the side of Triple Alliance against Triple Entente in 1914, when the First World War broke out. So, gained Cyprus from what? From Turkey. And Britain used it as a base for her Mediterranean Sea trade. France, what did France gain? France, represented by Waddington, actually gained an upper hand in the Turkish North African states, in the Turkish North African state of Tunisia. France later, in fact, history has it that France was bracketed, that is the best word which is used, that Bismarck bracketed France and promised France, Waddington, an upper hand in the Turkish North African state of Tunisia. And what happened in the long run? Later, in 1881, France occupied Tunisia. France occupied Tunisia. And when France occupied Tunisia, it accelerated the scramble by the great powers for the acquisition of the whole of North West African region. So the 1878 Berlin Congress accelerated the great powers' scramble for the occupation of North Africa and North West Africa. That's why eventually, after occupying Tunisia, France occupied Morocco, and then immediately after occupying Morocco, these other powers also got concerned. And what happened? Italy had to occupy Libya, Britain had to occupy Egypt. All of those were consequences of the Berlin Congress. In fact, I would have added it here that Britain culminated into her occupation, the British occupation of Egypt. British occupation of what? Egypt. Why? Because Britain had already gained a foothold, had already gained a foothold in the Mediterranean Sea, where Britain had gained control of Cyprus. So it was easy for Britain now to colonize and finally occupy Egypt. And then too, Britain was worried by the events in Tunisia. Britain was worried by what was taking place in the Northwest Africa. And therefore, Britain had to move so fast to safeguard her economic concerns in North Africa. And that's why in 1882, Britain occupied Egypt. We begin from there.